Hello everyone and welcome back to another baking video.
Today we're going to be making onbeetkoek, which is Dutch breakfast bread. So the first thing you're going to need to do is to preheat your oven to 148 degrees Celsius or slightly less depending on your oven. So the first thing you're going to need is a cup of rye flour, one cup of all-purpose flour, 3 teaspoons of baking powder, 2 teaspoons of cinnamon, 1/2 teaspoon of cardamom, ginger, ground coriander, ground cloves, 1/2 cup of brown sugar, 1/4 cup of molasses or dark treacle, 1/2 cup of honey, and 1 cup of milk and a pinch of salt. Dry ingredients into a bowl. Put the milk in to help combine them quicker and to dissolve the sugar. As you can see, look at it go, look at it go. Then you dump in the honey, and once that's in, you just combine everything together. Then you put in your treacle or molasses, whichever one you have decided to go for, it doesn't actually matter. You stir that in until, again, nicely combined. Don't want to see any marbly effect going on. Once that is all together, you want to get your herbs and spices, and you want to pop those in, just chuck them all in. And then admiring the autumnal colours, stirring it in. Folding is better than actually just mashing. Get your loaf tin, a medium-sized loaf tin will do, and line it with baking or parchment paper. Then, using a spatula, just empty the whole thing in. It's actually quite a simple way to do it. You just empty the whole lot in, you mix all the ingredients together, that's it. And then one very important thing to do is to fold the paper over, because it bakes for a very, very long time. You don't want to have any...
You don't want to burn the top.
Yeah, or any soggy bits underneath. Bake for 80 minutes, or sometimes a bit longer, depending on how hot your oven is. When you peel the paper off, it's going to look like nothing on earth, but that's okay, because again, it's a bit like one of our previous videos, if you've watched the apple tart recipe, everything is quite rustic looking, so again, this doesn't really matter. So here we are peeling off the bottom, and that comes away quite nicely, the top obviously not quite so well. So discard that, and then press it a little bit to see and get rid of any bits of paper, but do press it, see if it's spongy. It's actually when it's cooled, completely cooled down, you don't want to try and get rid of any paper when it's hot. and then admire your handiwork. Now this is, as far as it goes, I think it should be this sort of shape. I don't think it should be too tall. Then cut some slices. Top went a bit too crusty, I think. So we probably bake it a bit less next time. But the thing is, the middle is very, very moist. Now, this is one of my Oma's favourite things to do. She used to just cover it, didn't she? In just really thick butter. It doesn't matter about your arteries. Don't worry about your arteries for 5 minutes. Just enjoy it because it's lovely. And it just enhances the flavours of everything. Whenever I used to go around Oma's, we used to have this for breakfast or whatever time of the day, really. Okay, and then if there is only a couple of you, I would save a chunk of the cake, and you'll see why in another video, and enjoy. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next baking video. Bye.